These are Pakistani leaders in 1947, the year the country inherited its blasphemy law from British colonial heads when it gained independence. The original law made it a crime to deliberately offend religious sentiments of any group. It was designed to protect the religious freedom for everyone in Pakistan. During the 1980s, the laws were expanded and have since evolved to the point that it often threatens the safety of its citizens.
It's used against religious minorities and even against Muslim people to settle personal scores. And it's this blight on Pakistan's human rights record.
Dozens of people have been killed by vigilantes over accusations of blasphemy. And this is punishable by death, though it's never been enforced in Pakistan. A Pakistani Christian woman, Asia Bibi, was acquitted in 2018 over false blasphemy charges that had her spend 8 years on death row. Bibi now lives in Canada and fears for her life every day. In another case, thousands of radical Islamists rallied in July in support of a man who gunned down a fellow Muslim on trial for blasphemy.
When the judge fears for their life more than actually focusing on whether or not the accusations against you are fair, that really sort of compounds the fear factor.
Amnesty International says the blasphemy laws in Pakistan fail to safeguard the accused and encourage people to take the law into their own hands, often using violence, a clear violation, they say, of human rights. There has been a push to amend blasphemy laws, but no major political party has followed through because of fears of antagonizing religious parties.
Thanks for watching Global News. If you want to stay up to date on the latest breaking national and international news, be sure to subscribe to our channel.